Welcome back, learners, in the subject of integrated marketing communication and brand management. Today we are going to talk about the branding challenges and opportunities in detail. In earlier lecture, we have talked about what is brand management. We have seen meaning of brand. Today we are going to see, we'll start the lecture with the branding challenges which are faced by the brand manager. So what will be the role of brand manager in making a brand, and what will be the challenges which are faced by them during the branding process? We are going to see each and every point in detail. So in branding challenges, we have the 5 C's of challenges, that is cache, consistency, clutter, connectivity and communication cost. We will see them by one by one. So we'll start with the cache. So the challenges of cache dealing with the short-term financial concern is the biggest single channel which is faced by the brand managers nowadays. So it is driven by a very simple exercise, that is executive needs to deliver the short-term financial result, but brands are long-term asset, right? So executive who deliver quarterly profits are rewarded likewise, but however, all of the brand value resides in the future as well as the current financial details. So the brand value is a very small part of total financial results. However, if a manager is forced to choose between investing a brand and missing short-term financial targets, most manager will choose to hit the short-term numbers, and that is why the cash crunch will be always an challenge for the manager front. Now, when we talk about the branding, we know that there will be overall brand strength which we have to build. But long-term, when we talk about the branding, the long-term brand prospect decline as overall brand strength decline due to the lack of the brand building programs. So prices or the margin come under the pressure due to the competitive response, and that is why customers start expecting more price promotion, or they will delay their purchases because in expectation of the price promotional offers. So the perceived price value shift downwards, and similarly the brand which gets into a very dangerous spiral, downward spiral, and that is why we have to concentrate on the cash crunch, which will most of the time helps executives to fulfill the short-term financial role and not the long-term one. And that is why most of the time brand manager ignores the branding thing over the short-term objectives. Next challenges we have is consistency. So brands are created through a wide range of touch points. So every time a customer interacts with a brand, they form association. So this means that everyone in a company has an impact on that brand. So therefore, the central objective of brand building is to keep the message consistent across all the platforms, all the media and all the time. So this requires keeping the brand relevant by finding the new ways to articulate your message so that it becomes or it stays consistent. So this means making appropriate changes across the board consistently and adopting stay on the top of the trend is necessity in the branding thing. However, many brands are unable to present a unified message across all the platforms. Taking an example, suppose a brand may be otherwise have a good online store, but its social media profiles may not be up to the mark. So other brand follows another descriptive part also, which is separating their online and offline offerings. So then there is a second biggest challenge of branding, its consistency. So getting an entire organization to embrace the brand, live up to the promise over time is very difficult, and that is where the consistency is next challenge in the branding. Third challenge we have is clutter. So the market, here we are talking about the market. So the market is intensively competitive and it is increasingly populated. So consumers are bombarded every day by hundreds of, sometimes thousands of advertisement and the promotion. So breaking through that cluttered environment is very difficult. And the challenge is to be unique as well as to stand out among the crowd. And that is where you will become the brand. But this challenge is very difficult to achieve, and you have to be innovative in your marketing as well, and you have to carve out your niche for in the advertising. So it is very hard to get anyone's attention on your brand. So it is very harder to still to form a meaningful association also. So to stand out the brand needs to be more focused and unique. So great brand means something in unique in the consumer mind. So getting that clear positioning is very difficult nowadays. Next branding challenge you have is connectivity. So brands are created through a wide range of touch points. So every time a customer interacts with the brand, they form the association, but whether it is emotionally or mentally or physical association. But this means that everyone in a company has an impact on that brand, right? So everywhere the biggest challenge of branding is nothing but to connect those people. So in ever over connected world also, it is very truer than ever that consumer consider brand that are relevant to them only. So they fulfill their desire to express themselves. And however, due to cluttered market and rising expenditure to build the brands in the market, it becomes more important to ensure that you will be very clear and consistent with your communication of your brand identity and positioning. And that is why in connectivity, to connect with the consumer in a right and efficient way is very important. That is a big challenge in front of the brand manager. Next challenge you have is the communication. So the brand of the company is created by the company and the customer together, right? So the strongest brand will be the ones to which the consumer becomes so attached that they are in effect become very active, or they are seeking to interact with the brand, and they will share their experiences with the others. So firms that are able to achieve this resonance or the affinity with their customer would be able to reap a host of the valuable benefits, such as the greater premiums or the more efficient and effective marketing programs. Digital media again dictates the marketers to relinquish control of the story as customer want to interact with the brand, and how they are modifying that message over the social media. So the communication is very important challenge for the brand management for the brand manager to explore the branding thing. Next you have is, which is the sixth challenge for branding, is considering a branding as an asset is very difficult for managers. So the pressure on branding is nothing but to deliver the short-term financial gains, as we have discussed in the cash point. But to take most of the organizational decision maker have to focus more on such measurable tactics, and therefore we often neglect that the branding is an asset and not a liability. So most of the time brand manager neglects the objective of building brand or the building asset of brand. So this is also another challenge of a brand manager. Next you have is some financial challenges we have. So in financial, no, next we have is, yes, correct, financial challenges. So in financial challenges, a sensible budget should be allocated specifically for the branding. So along with the marketing, you should have another budget thing for the branding also, which will significantly consideration to make. But in fact, various business are coming with this thing, branding, budgeting differently. But many a times, what happens in businesses, they are failed to do budgeting efficiently. And that is why there are some financial challenges in branding also. So we have seen the different branding challenges. Now we will talk about the branding opportunities. So in branding opportunities, we have different opportunities in branding. The first one we have is define your persona. So here we are talking about the organizational persona or the product persona. So create a better value proposition. It becomes essential for the seller to replicate your buyer persona perfectly. So understanding their need or the behavior or the goals of the target group has to be conveyed through the core brand values, and that is very good opportunity for the brand managers also. Second we have is having a strong internet presence. So once if you build a social media branding strategy, it is very essential to be persistent and as well as the consistent regarding the branding efforts to keep on the top of the competition. We all know that today's generation is very internet savvy, and that is why having a strong internet presence will help us to make more efficient branding. The next we have is blogging for branding. So nowadays blogging, because people are at their home and there is pandemic going on, so most of the people are spending their most of the time on the internet. So blogging is another thing which you can capture for branding. So along with the social media, blogging is also ideal branding strategy. So a blog is not only to promote the products, but it will share the information which the target group consumers value. So sometimes when you scroll up the Facebook, you will see some blogs like 10 products which skincare products under $5.99. You click on that blog and you will get the information wherein they are tagging some online shoppers of particular brands. So these is nothing but blogging nowadays, a very popular and famous way of doing branding nowadays. So it will create situation over time where the users will search for you individually. So it will based on the unique brand elements that you have already formed, and that this customer will stay loyal towards your branding. Next you have is customer service as a priority. As I always said, as we have already seen, that customer service is very important element in branding, because we all know that making customer service a key focus of the brand building, and it will succeed if we have save money regarding advertising or marketing. So branding is if you are giving the customer service as a priority, you are keeping customer service as a priority, then you will save your money which you otherwise spend over the advertising or other marketing tactics. So branding is generally more of a general word of a mouth recognition among the potential customer, which will not fade quickly, and that is why making customer service will be a wise opportunity for the brand manager. Next you have is opportunity from technology. So brand marketers are now able to take the advantage of technology to gain more and more competitive advantage through the time. So technology is already reducing the lead time which need to respond rapidly to changing customers' need, or minimizing any delays in the supply chain. So that can be happened with the help of the technology. Next thing, because there is increase in more and more sophisticated buyers in business to business marketing, there is already an emphasis on bringing together the individual from different departments to evaluate the supplier's new brand. So as interdepartmental barriers break down even more, sellers are going to face increasingly sophisticated buyers who are served by better information system, and they will unable to pair up the brand supplier against each other. So as if more sophisticated buyers do have the better information knowledge, you have that opportunity to grab those buyers right now, right away. By getting them, it will help you in your product development, and it will help you to develop the processes which may be hampering your sales. So that is very important opportunity. The last opportunity we have is the growth of corporate branding. So nowadays we known n number of corporates who do have their branding name. So taking an example of TCS, so with media inhabiting the individual brand advertising, many firms are putting more emphasis on the corporate branding. So they are unifying their portfolio of brands through very clear linkage with the corporation, which clarifies all the lines which brands adhere to. So most of the corporates are going for branding thing nowadays, and that will create opportunities for the brand manager to think on a global level or on an international level for the brand or for branding perspective. So that's it. We have seen the various challenges and opportunities in branding. We will conclude the lecture that for new entrepreneurs, building a brand may be seen to be very massive undertaking, especially when the resources or the budget are limited. But however, if suppose we had seen over above, like we do have lots of technology around us, we do have various media strategies which we can use. So there are many economic and practical ways to start with the branding and keep the momentum up with the consistent and the insightful efforts. So branding has to be made a culture, and of course you need to enjoy and have fun with this creative process to take it on the top. So that's it for today's lecture. Until next lecture, please stay tuned and please subscribe to the channel of GS College of Commerce for the e-learning. Thank you.